नमस्ते एंड गुड मॉर्निंग डियर किड्स. टुडे वी विल रीड न्यू लेसन हेलेन केलर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. इट वॉज द समर ऑफ 1880. अ हेल्दी बेबी गर्ल वॉज बॉर्न इन अ स्मॉल टाउन इन अलबामा. हर पेरेंट्स लव्ड हर डियरली एंड नेम्ड हर हेलेन केलर. But one day the baby became ill, and day after day her fever stayed high. Everyone in the family tried to help her get better, but all they could say was, "There is nothing more we can do. The baby may not live." So, dear children, this is a story about a girl whose name is Helen Keller. And when she was born in the summer of 1880. And where she was born? She was born in a small town in Alabama. Alabama is a country in United States of America. But one day what happened, dear kids? Although she was born healthy, but one day she became ill. And she was not getting better. Day by day, her fever stayed high. So everyone in the family tried their best to make her better. But the only thing they could say was, everyone in the family tried to help her in every possible way, but all they could say was, "There is nothing more we can do." That means they are losing hope. They have tried everything possible to make her better, but finally they said, "The baby may not live." Helen lived, but she was not the same after her illness. "Something is very wrong," her mother said. At last, they found out what was wrong. The child could not see or hear. So, dear children, although Helen survived that fever, she became better. She lived, but there was something very wrong about her. So, finally, the parents figured out that the child is no longer the same. The child now could not see or hear. The baby grew into a little girl. Her parents felt sorry for her. Helen often cried and held on to her mother. "Give the poor child what she wants," her father would say. So, dear kid, although Helen lived, but she was no longer the same. Now, what is wrong with the child? That the child could not see or hear. Now this Helen Keller has grew into a little girl. Her parents felt very sad. Her parents felt very sorry, and they were always worried about her. She'll often held on to her mother. Most of the time she held on to her mother and she's crying. And his helpless father would say, "Please give the poor child what she wants." Yani bacha jo bhi cha raha hai, whatever she is demanding, just give it to her. Just calm her down. Though Helen could not hear or see, she was a bright little girl. Some people thought Helen could not learn anything. Her mother did not agree. "Helen is very smart," she said, and added, "The problem is, how can we reach her? She's locked up inside herself." So, although Helen could not see or hear, but she was a smart girl. She was ready to learn things, but what was the problem? She was locked inside herself. Dear kids, here, locked inside herself means that neither she can see nor she can hear. So whatever we want to tell her, whatever message we want to convey to her, we cannot tell her. So they have to find a way to reach the child. They have to find a way by which they can convey their thoughts, they can convey their message to that little girl. Helen began to grow wild. She would not let anyone comb her hair. Her clothes were always dirty. She was often angry. Sometimes she even lay on the floor and kicked her feet. So, you know, these days when we are locked inside our houses due to this lockdown, you also might have felt like you are fed up and you might grow wild and angry. I want to go out. In the same way, as Helen could not see anything, she cannot hear. Only thing that she could do is she can touch and feel. So she was growing wild day by day. She also want to explore the world, but she's not finding how she can do that. Now what is going on? She's growing wild. She's not letting anyone come closer. She's not letting anyone comb her hair. Her clothes were always dirty, and she is very often very angry. Her parents thought that they should find a teacher for her. Miss Sullivan, a young teacher, agreed to help Helen to learn to see the world. Miss Sullivan gave Helen a doll. D-O-L-L spells doll. She spelled the word with her fingers into Helen's hand. So now the parent found one solution. What they did, they said, we need a teacher who can reach Helen, who can tell her how she can explore this world. So one young teacher, Miss Sullivan, agreed that she will help Helen to see the world. So what she did, she gave Helen a doll, and with the help of her fingers, she spelled D-O-L-L on her hand. So dear kids, you can also try this. Try spelling D-O-L-L on your wrist or on your hand. See, you can feel the movement of your fingers. So in the same way, Helen is reached by this teacher, she will write something, some words on her wrist, and she'll feel it, and by those movements of her fingers, she identifies which object she is talking about. Helen copied her teacher and spelled D-O-L-L too, but she did not understand what she was doing. Helen liked Miss Sullivan. She was strict but kind. She spelled a lot of words for Helen on her hand, day and night, to make Helen understand. So what is happening now, dear kids? This young teacher, Miss Sullivan, she's very strict but kind also. She used to spell so many words for Helen on her hand day and night to make Helen understand. That means she's trying her best. She's day and night there. She's helping Helen. She's writing some words, spelling some words on her hand so that she can identify different objects with those movements of fingers on her hand or wrist. One day, her teacher made Helen put her hand into running water. Then she spelled W-A-T-E-R. Suddenly, Helen understood that W-A-T-E-R meant something wet running over her hand. She understood that words were the most important things in the world. Words would tell her everything she wanted to know. What happened one day her teacher made Helen put her hand into running water, and as Helen put her hand into running water, her teacher spelled W-A-T-E-R on her hand. So this girl Helen quickly understood that W-A-T-E-R, this is a word which means something wet running over her hand. With this incident, dear kids, she also understood that words are very important thing in this world. That means words will tell her everything she wanted to know. Now, as you all know, we have given name, we have given particular words to everything. So if she want to understand this world, what she has to do, she should learn about these words. These words can tell her everything she want to know about this world which she could not see or hear. Dear kids, I must tell you, this is a real life story of this girl Helen Keller. And as she grew up, she became the first blind person to graduate. That means she completed her college life despite the fact that she could not see or hear. So dear kids, what we can learn from this lesson is we all have shortcomings, but the only thing that matters is how we conquer it, how we overcome it.